Yes, sir.
Yes, Vinay. Good morning. How are you?
Sir, fine, sir. How are you, sir?
I am good, Vinay. Vinay, when is your interview?
Sir, it's on 12th Jan.
12th Jan. Okay.
Yes.
Vinay, can you quickly tell us something about yourself?
Sir, my name is Vinay. I did my schooling and my high schooling from Mulund, Mumbai itself. Then I went to KJ Somaiah College of Science and Commerce, where I did my BSc in Statistics. Sir, then I completed my Master's in Statistics from Pondicherry Central University. Okay. And then since 1 year, I'm preparing for various competitive examination. And I have also given the Indian Statistical Service Examination 2019. Mm-hmm. And I cleared mains in that. And so I did. I went for interview, but I didn't qualified for the final appointment due to less. Like I got 14 marks less in that for the final appointment.
Okay.
And now I have given NABARD mains and I have cleared that.
Okay, Vinay, can you give me 3 synonyms of your name in Hindi?
Sir, Vinay means Vinamra. It's a name of Ganesh. It is also called as like it is Ganesh name also, Vinayak. So it resembles that. And sir, I am not able to recollect the 3 synonyms, but I know that it means Vinamra. That okay. Vinay means Vinamra.
Good enough. Vinay, as I could see that you have a very, very good academic background. That means graduation scoring 83% above, MSc scoring 90% above. So why do you want to join NABARD? You could have easily got very good research-based institutes or statistical-based institute. You could have also joined as a data analyst or data scientist at some very good corporate as well. So why NABARD?
Sir, when I went through NABARD website, sir, I got to know that NABARD through its 3 department, financial, supervision and developmental, it touches each and every aspect of rural economy. Mm-hmm. So it would provide me gamut of opportunities, and I think the NABARD provides better promotional avenues. So I think in NABARD I will find me much more developed. So I think I would like to join NABARD for that.
So is this the only reason, that is development and promotion, that is attracting you towards NABARD, or is there some any other reason as well?
No, sir. It will provide me various opportunities. Like if we see, there is one posting what I have seen from when I was going through NABARD website. There is a district development manager post where we have to do ground level work. So it will provide me various opportunities in various fields. Mm-hmm. In statistics as well. So that's why I decided to go for NABARD.
Okay, fair enough. Vinay, can you tell me what are the 3 major sources of revenue for NABARD?
Sir, NABARD, one of the sources is Rural Infrastructure Development Fund. Mm-hmm. Sir, when banks have their PSL quota, that is priority sector lending quota, and if they don't meet that, then they're excess, that the remaining amount has to be deposited in the Rural Infrastructure Development Fund. So that is one of the source, and which is the largest source for NABARD. And the second source is bonds and debentures, sir. Sir, NABARD issues bonds and debentures through which it funds its programs. And also, sir, there are commercial borrowing loans from foreign currencies as well. So that are the 3, one of the major sources of NABARD.
Have you heard of that? One of the sources is reserves and surplus as well.
Sir, I have seen that, but I am not able to recollect the meaning of that, sir.
Okay. Since you mentioned about bonds and debentures as one of the sources, can you tell me what is the basic difference between bonds and debentures?
Sir, bonds, as far as my knowledge, sir, bonds gives interest every year. Like it is a safe as compared to debentures. Sir, I don't know much difference about that, sir.
So debentures don't give interest, is that so?
No, it gives, sir, but it is a little more risky as per bonds, I think.
Can you take a try, or can you take a guess that why it is more risky?
Sir, no, sir, no.
Okay. Not a problem. Sorry, sir. Not a problem. There has been a lot of talks regarding the Blue Revolution in India, and NABARD has been one of the eminent institutions promoting Blue Revolution. So can you quickly do a SWOT analysis for me for the fishery sector in India?
Fishery sector in India? Yes. Sir, what exactly, sir? Sorry, I am not getting
SWOT
your
analysis.
Question.
SWOT analysis of fishery sector.
Sir, have Fisher disease.
Have you heard of SWOT analysis?
Sir, I have heard, but I'm not able to recollect the meaning of that.
Strength, weakness, opportunity, yes. Threat.
Okay, okay, that one, right, sir.
Can you now answer this question?
Yes, sir. Sir, fisheries is one of the sunrise sector industry in India. It is growing at a much faster pace, and I think it provides sustainable opportunities for employment. And the strengths are of fisheries sector is that we India have a large coastline of our around 6,500 kilometers. So there is a lot of opportunities.
Very good. Go ahead.
Weaknesses is that, sir, we are lacking much more in infrastructure. So if we compare our fisheries sector with that of foreign countries, we lack with much of vessels, fisheries, huge advanced vessels, we lack in that. Mm-hmm. And also we don't prefer much fishing activities in deep sea. We mostly prefer in coastline area. Mm-hmm. So that is there. So, and our government, our present government have launched various initiatives with respect to fisheries. One of them, as far as I remember, is Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana is one of them that is there. And threats for the present fisheries sector is that...
Opportunities, Vinay. What are the opportunities?
Sir, opportunities... Sir, that key, we have not explored much more about that. So if we go for much deep fishing activities, then it can lead to a lot of development. There is a lot of consumption is there. In India, consumption of fish is there. So we have a lot of opportunities for that, sir, I think. And threats is that, threat is that because of climate change and other factors and due to increase in pollution, the fisheries that we see today are facing a lot of issue. Because of pollution, sir, they are not getting much oxygen because of oil spilling and such other activities. The oxygen level is depleting in water. So that is one of the threats which is endangering.
Good enough. Now, one of the threats is a lot of anti-dumping duties have been imposed by the export destinations. So can you tell me any three types of anti-dumping measures that any country can take?
Sir, one of the measures is by increasing taxes, custom duties on the country which is doing dumping. One is that restrict like if a country which is importing from another country, then the tag of main source destination, that is also one of them measure that I have went through. Sir, I'm not able to recollect the third one.
No problem. Vinay, since you're from statistics background, can you quickly tell me in brief that if the value of R is given to be 0.6, what is going to be the value of R square and what is going to be its interpretation?
Sir, R is the correlation coefficient and R square is a multiple correlation coefficient. So R square will be 0.36. And the interpretation of is that the total variation in the dependent variable that we are going to talk, that let's say it be Y, then the variation in Y, the 36% of variation, total variation in Y is explained by the explanatory variables that we take.
Great. One additional question with respect to this. What is the difference between R square and adjusted R square?
Sir, R square, if we see, so when we add explanatory variables, the value of R square will increase. So it is an increasing function of explanatory variable. But whereas adjusted R square is not. So when the explanatory variable is significantly affecting the dependent variable, that is Y, then only that adjusted R square value will increase. Otherwise, it may fall down also. So R square value may go in negative also. But the R square, adjusted R square value may go in negative also. But the R square value is always positive and it is increasing function of explanatory variable.
You got selected in NABARD and you're posted in a statistics department. So as a statistician or as a data analyst, which of these is going to be more significant to you and why? Adjusted R square or R square?
sir, I'll go through. I'll go with adjusted R square, sir.
Why so?
Sir, because it shows the real trend. Because sir, what happens is usually in statistical modeling, what we do when we see at R square is increasing, so we add more and more explanatory variable, making our model bulky. But it may not be the case. So it may lead to cost overruns because we are adding explanatory variable. But if it is not significantly important, then we are wasting our resources also. So right. That's why, sir, I will go with adjusted R square, and it will do the true picture of our.
Now, my last question to you is, of lately, NABARD has been taking a lot of steps in the sustainable development per se. So can you tell me in this relation, what is the concept of triple bottom line approach of sustainability?
Sir, I'm not sure with the triple bottom line.
Okay. So that's all from my side. Over to you, Mani, sir.
Hello, Vinay, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Vinay, you have done your MSc in statistics. Can you just tell me what is the difference between independent events and mutually exclusive events?
Sir, independent event is the one independent where one event is not dependent on other, whereas mutually exclusive event may not be independent.
All right. And have you heard of the term kurtosis?
K-U-R-T-O-S-I-S.
What is that?
Sir, kurtosis of any distribution, sir, it represents the height of the distribution. So it shows a peakedness, if specificity, like it shows a peakedness of the distribution.
Okay. Now, can you tell me what is the difference between a heat engine and a diesel engine? You also have studied physics in your graduation, so you must have known about this.
Sir, I'm not able to recollect. Sorry, sir.
All right, no issues. So we recently have saw that government has implemented the BS6 emission norms, right?
Yes, sir.
And earlier there was BS4. So why there is a jump from?
Sir, I'm not able to hear you.
From BS4 to BS6, there has BS5 missing.
Sir, can you repeat the question because the internet connection? Ha, sir. Yes, sir. I'm able to hear you.
Yeah. So my question was ki we have seen the implementation of BS6 emission norms, and earlier it was BS4. Yes, so sir. Why is it there is a jump directly from BS4 to BS6? Why? Where is this BS5 missing?
Sorry, sir. I'm not sure with that.
All right. So one more question I would like to ask. Can you tell me what are some limitations associated with the usage of solar cells and how we can improve that?
Limitation of solar cell.
Yeah. Okay, no issues. So can you tell me what is the difference between a government company and a statutory body? Or is there any difference?
Sir, statutory body... Sir, it is same as far as my knowledge, sir.
Okay.
It is so notified in the constitution.
Okay, no issues. Vinay, my next question to you is, can you tell me about any 5 contribution of information technology in Indian economy, specifically in the banking sector?
Sir, information technology, sir, if we see our GDP is mostly contributed by service sector. So the role information technology has played is very important. And in banking sector, if we see the core banking solution, if we talk about. So now a person can do transaction from any of the branches today. So that is because of the information technology. That is one of the major contributing factor by information technology. And sir, today we have internet banking, now fintech companies are there. So data analysis has done. So it has led to improvement in the penetration of banking in India. So that is the main important, I think, these are the more important contributions of information technology.
Okay. So you must have heard of RTGS, NEFT and IMPS. Can you tell me what is the difference between them?
So I don't know the specificity of this, all these three things.
All right, two issues. Have you heard of the term Greenfield project?
Sir, I have heard about it, but like
Okay, so Government of India is promoting zero budget natural farming these days. Do you know what is this zero budget natural farming?
Yes, sir. Zero budget natural farming is a type of farming in where the total input cost turns out to be zero. So all the things are to be done naturally. So in this, mostly natural fertilizers are being used. So that is there, and I am not able to.
Okay, so you are saying that if we are using natural things, then it is zero budget natural farming, right?
Connects.
Hello.
Sir, wait.
Yeah.
The voice actually was not coming.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
Now, sir. Okay, now it's
okay. Yeah, so you are saying that if you are using natural things in our agriculture, then that is known as zero budget natural farming. Is it?
It is one of the components, or the other components I'm not able to recollect.
So,
one of the components it is.
Sir. Recently, a union territory has been declared as the 100% union, 100% organic union territory.
She are net
connected. Shubham sir, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, absolutely. I think there is some issue with Vinay's connection.
All right, sir.
Sir, 1 minute, sir. My net connection is getting unstable, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Okay,
Vinay. I'll switch to another source.
All right.
No problem, Vinay. You can take your time. Don't worry.
Yes, sir. Stand alone. Loco. One minute, huh?
Hello.
Ah, sir. Now it's okay, sir.
Okay.
Sorry, can sir, you... for the disturbance. Yes, sir.
No issues. Can you hear me now properly?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So my question is, recently.
Manish, sir, but you're not visible.
Yes, sir.
You is switched on, sir.
So you are still not visible, Manish, sir.
Yeah, I think there is an issue.
Vinay, just a minute. Just wait for 1 minute. I think Manish sir is working upon the technical issue.
Okay, sir. No problem, sir.
So, is it okay now?
Yes, perfect.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I was asking, Vinay, recently a union territory has been declared as the 100% organic union territory. Can you tell me what is the name of that UT?
Sir, Sikkim, sir.
So, but that is a state, no? I'm asking about union territory.
Right. Sorry, sir. So, union territory, I'm not sure about that.
Okay. No issues. Now, can you just tell me the names of 5 central government schemes which are there for the agricultural development?
Sir, for agriculture, both for agriculture and rural development.
No, just for the agriculture.
Sir, for agriculture, there is one scheme, Kusum scheme is there. Kusum scheme is one of them. The second scheme is, I'll tell about rural development, sir. One scheme of rural development is Manrega scheme is there. Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee scheme is one of them. The second one is, sir, Ayushman Bharat is also there. It is not with respect to rural development, but the population mostly it caters is the low income people. So that is one of them. Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana is one of them with respect to agriculture.
Okay, Vinay, no problem.
Sir, ha.
No issues. Last question, Vinay, from my side. Can you throw some light on the NABARD's balance sheet? How is it going and where do you see NABARD 10 years from now?
Sir, frankly speaking, sir, I have not gone through NABARD balance sheet, sir.
Okay, so one more question I would like to ask, Vinay. How you can use your knowledge of statistics while working at the NABARD? Give me any three ways.
Sir, if we see NABARD is going very digital with its initiative, let it be eShakti platform, Ensure platform. So the amount of data that is going to come is going to increase. So where their statistics can be used. And sir, now if we see NABARD and other banks where NABARD funds are mostly catering to that sector of population which lacks credit history. So by the use of statistics, we can use proxies for their credit history, and we can cater different products to them. So in that way, statistics can be used very much. And also, if we see, sir, now statistics has been used in various government scheme. So, and NABARD recently have taken various surveys. One of them recently was done, sir, I'm not able to recollect that name, but it was with respect to determining the income of the farmers. In 2018, it was done with the aim of promoting our honorable Prime Minister vision of doubling farmer income. So that way, NABARD is conducting various surveys. So statistics can be used in future surveys as well. So in that way, statistics can be very useful, sir.
Okay, Vinay, so that is all from my side. Shubham, sir.
Vinay, I have one more question. So it is being said that there are three kinds of lies. Lies, damn lies, and then it comes about statistics. So can you just explain this statement to me?
Sir. In statistics, if we see, as we are playing with data, sir, so naturally what happens, the data that is presented to us, so it can be seen through various angles, sir, and it can be used maliciously also. So one can say it is not that, but one can say lies with statistics. So it can be said that one can play with data in anyhow, and then they can produce what they want. So that's why it is in that context, that statement.
Okay. One last question from my side is, can you tell me what is an Altman Z score model?
So I have not heard about that. Sorry, sir.
Okay. That's all from my side. Okay. Now, Vinay, coming to your feedback. So you are a wonderful candidate. You have a very good personality. You have a very pleasing personality. Your voice quality is good. Confidence is very good. The best thing is you are able to justify your background coming from statistics. So I asked you quite detailed technical questions related to adjusted R-square and all these things. You were able to answer them. And therefore, if the panel gets into statistics, they're definitely going to ask technical questions. And I feel you will be able to justify those questions. One suggestion from my side to you is that when you are asked about the question for NABARD, then rather than focusing on promotion, development, these are the reasons, but these should be the secondary reason. First, try to make a connection from your background towards NABARD. That, sir, I think that statistics is one thing that plays a very crucial role in any apex institution as well as for an economy. And I think that I, coming from a statistics background, can help frame certain policies or can help make certain interpretations that can be a lot more useful for the economy as well as for agriculture and rural development. So first try to make a linkage from your background, educational background towards NABARD. Then come to your interest that probably, sir, now I'm interested into agricultural growth and development also. Then come to that, yes, sir, there are various opportunities also. There are various diversities also. Don't let them feel that this candidate is just willing to come to NABARD just because of the perks, emoluments and all these stuff. Okay.
Right. Huh?
Right.
So okay,
this,
sir.
This is one.
And sir, one more thing.
Yeah, we'll come to your question.
No, sir.
Come to
your
question, sir. Yeah.
Okay. No problem.
And I think some basics brushing up on like banking and finance would be much. See, you are good at statistics. You're good with NABARD things. Okay. Just focus a little bit on banking and financial parts as well. Okay. And rest, I think Mani sir would be able to better tell you. Mani sir.
Yeah. So in my opinion also, Vinay, you are a very good candidate. Your voice quality is very good. You have a very pleasing personality, but you have to work on some areas. Like you have to work about basics of NABARD, right? When I asked you about the balance sheet of NABARD, you didn't know that. So I think you have to work on the basics of NABARD. And for that, you can follow the annual report of NABARD, which is there on their website. Okay.
Right, sir.
And other than this, I think you are very good too. And the best thing, which I have noticed, that various questions that I asked, you were not able to answer, but uske baad bhi, you were not that nervous. So that was very good. Okay. Is cheez ko aapko interview mein maintain karke rakhna hai. Okay. And that is all the best.
Yes, Vinay, you want to ask something?
Sir, yes, sir. That I was getting little nervous so that I was not able to recollect the schemes of agriculture. So I was knowing that agriculture schemes, I have done that. And sir, since I have not studied economics, like in my, till my post graduation, I have not studied. So that RTGS and NAFT thing, I was not able to like properly.
That is banking, Vinay.
But sir, I have to do that. But I will do, sir.
हाँ, वो banking का part है, Vinay. That is not economics.
Right, sir. हाँ.
So they are definitely going to ask some basics on banking, as I told you, because NABARD is an apex bank, in agriculture bank. So ultimately, कुछ basics तो पूछेंगे वो banking से. Be prepared.
Okay, so the different types of banks I have to do, and this, then different payment systems and all that.
Yes.
Little bit, yes, basics.
Yes. Basics of banking in terms of what are their policies, what are their measures, like the policies used by RBI, like the quantitative and qualitative instruments. Thoda bahut in sari cheezon ke bare mein pad lenge, so it will be good because you are already a good candidate. So
okay, sir.
Don't flung on a particular area. Jo aapka weak point hai, usko strength strong bana lijiye
thoda. Barabar, right sir. And sir, I'll go through that balance sheet also I will go through, because just I have went through the website, sir. I have covered the entire website of NABARD. It's developed all that functions and all that, but that's balance sheet, sir. I have to do, sir. I will go through that.
Kuch hoga.
Annual report.
Yes, annual report of NABARD pick kar lijiye. You will get everything about sustainability, you will get everything about blue revolution, fisheries, sab kuch mil jayega uske andar.
Okay, yes sir. Definitely, I will go through.
Okay,
that,
all the best, Vinay.
Yes, sir. Sir, thank you very much, sir. Thank you for all the insights, sir. Mani sir, also thank you, sir.
Most welcome.
All the best.
I'll definitely work on the areas where I'm weak, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
All the best.
Yes, sir. And sir, one thing.
Yeah.
Sir, should I mention about my UPSC attempt?
Not until they have asked, because I don't think so. You must have exhausted it. You have exhausted your attempts?
No, sir. I have given two mains of Indian Statistical Service, and in both that I have qualified. Like I have until interview stage.
See, since your passing out is 2019. Since your passing out is 2019.
Yes, sir.
So I don't think it's they're gonna get into the details. जब तक डिटेल में नहीं पूछ रहे, यू आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. आई डोंट थिंक यू कैन सिंपली से दैट सर, आई हैव बीन आफ्टर पासिंग आउट, आई हैव बीन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स, वेरियस कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स.
ओके,
नाउ आई हैव क्लियर NABARD मेंस. अंटिल दे आस्क, अंटिल दे गेट
इट, ओके, सो ओके,
कि कौन से क्लियर हुए, व्हाट आर द
स्टेट्स,
राइट सर. हां, इट्स नॉट रिक्वायर्ड.
ओके, सो आई शुड नॉट मेंशन टिल दे आस्क.
ओके, हां, डिटेल यू कैन,
सो आई शुड नॉट टेल डायरेक्टली.
हां, बिकॉज़ गैप नहीं है ना, विनय, जनरली क्या होता है जो कैंडिडेट्स आते हैं उनके 4-5 साल के गैप होते हैं, ऑल दोस कैंडिडेट्स हुम वी आर इंटरव्यूइंग, जैसे 2015 में उन्होंने अपनी पढ़ाई खत्म करी, देन 4-5 इयर्स गैप इज देयर, सो डेफिनेटली दे आर गोना गेट इनटू की 4-5 साल से क्या कर रहे थे, आपकी सिचुएशन में वो है नहीं,
राइट सर,
सो अननेसेसरी लेट्स नॉट ब्रिंग समथिंग दैट पुल्स यू डाउन.
यस यस,
ऑल द बेस्ट,
राइट, ऑल द बेस्ट विनय, ओके सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, थैंक यू सर.